Nothing about us without us.
Thank you, and see you there soon.
Just so much energy amongst the participants. I mean, it's really, really exciting to see people for the first time coming from different continents of the world, you know, who've been themselves, all of them being through the experience of being forcibly displaced.
When we started today, I was so moved because there's so much emotions involved because we're making history.
Where refugees have their own representation.
Finally that happened and it was unbelievable that we are here.
This is the first ever global summit for refugees by refugees.
This is something all we're proud of.
67 people from 22 countries, which has inspired me on so many levels.
It's not about having a group of people discussing how refugees are facing their challenges or should live their lives. Refugees are taking the initiative and taking the space, having the power and the agency to
be the center of migration and asylum policies.
Because it is all about us. Nothing about us without us.
I am really, really happy to be involved and to be part of this magnificent summit here today, the first ever global summit on refugees, by refugees, with refugees, for refugees.
This summit itself is, you know, it's not perfectly representative, and no summit like this ever will be, but this is the first time that we have people from Latin America, North America, Africa, Middle East, Europe, Asia and the Pacific all together in the one place, talking about common issues and a common future.
Today is a day where more than 80 people of refugee background and refugees took the initiative.
We are part of this and we are the most legitimate part in this front.
We refugees have to make the decision for us, and with this conference we are trying to turn as a policy makers for ourselves.
Esta ha sido una jornada muy emocionante porque compartimos historias de vida vinculadas no solamente al drama humano del refugio, sino que venimos avanzando en construirnos como un actor social, un actor colectivo, para proponer alternativas frente a la situación actual que enfrenta el refugio.
I met a lot of people from the same background. A lot of them, they participating in decision making, which is a very fantastic idea to make refugee able to make their own choice.
We thought advocacy together with migration group would also be a good option.
Refugees today are being fought on every single front. From we see people who are willing to go to jail or take boats and stop them from coming and seeking out refuge. And so the current response is being questioned, and I think that only refugees themselves can offer a new way, a new path of how to interact, not only to engage with the UNHCR and these actors and the international community, but also to create the synergies and the change that they want to be, the change that they want to see. And by having them all in the room together today, we can see this emerging and that force being created.
The refugees try to have their inputs on what is missing, what they would like to add on this policy, because when we listen to refugees, we know what they need. Then the integration will be based and implemented on their needs.
What we have discussed on the durable solution is really a lot of the voices. There is not much focus on resettlement as one of the durable solution now. And the discussion is now more focused on such as voluntary, you know, return or the successful integration or even like scholarship for education.
We discussed that we need like a new agreement and a new convention that based in basic new needs for refugees.
J'ai vraiment j'ai appris beaucoup de choses parce qu'on apprend toujours. Donc c'est vrai que j'ai apporté aussi mes expériences, des exemples. J'ai pu apprendre des autres, de ce qui se passe chez eux, disons dans les autres continents ou dans les autres pays. Et en plus, ils ont aussi compris ce qui se passe en Europe ici.
I felt empowered. I didn't feel that I'm alone in this front. For the first time, I heard about refugee experiences that are dealing with problems, though not identical to our problems in Europe, for example, but it's the same kind of struggle, it's the same kind of battle that we all share.
And I compare my problems with others, and they see that how I face the problems and how I found the solution for them.
And what is the action, or what is the some of the positive and negatives towards the refugees in their country?
In terms of networking, our group found that on global level, refugee-led organizations and some NGOs need to provide legal support to less fortunate refugee-led associations.
On national level, our network have to assign evidence-based researchers in specified areas of concerns.
The achievements and goals are really in the hands of the participants, not for NGOs like the Refugee Council to determine. I mean, I'm sure already, only with part of the way through the first day of the summit, people have already gathered many ideas from others, which they will take back and apply in their own local circumstances. They've been inspired by others. Mutual inspiration is one important thing. You know, there will be discussion, throughout the 2 days of issues to take to UNHCR and to others. But I think also, the planning of some sort of ongoing international network, whatever form that will take, I think is critically important.
I think we should have it as a vision to actually to make our work lead to a global entity that work on refugee policy.
Es importante que los refugiados empecemos a encontrarnos, a construir un nosotros, no solamente en la demanda de la protección, sino en la construcción de propuestas y alternativas para el futuro.
To actually create a body that would be a representation or be a voice of refugee, to have them come and be a decision makers.
This summit is as a victory for refugees, like to be in the table and create your journey and your life for the future.
We're supporters of the Global Summit of Refugees, the first ever, a very, very exciting event, because we believe that people should be part of the diplomatic processes about them. And of course, the one group of people who are routinely excluded from diplomatic discussions about refugee policy are of course refugees themselves. One of the things that's really amazed me about this project is how quickly it's changed things. I mean, obviously sooner than that, I hope that there will be universal acceptance of the principle that there should be no discussion of refugee policy without refugees in the room. I think that's a cardinal principle that needs to be established and respected in all policy discussions, whether it's a city, a country, or the United Nations.
It's the start, and we look forward that the UNHCR, donor countries, NGOs listen to the voice of those refugees and give them space to represent themselves.